was the unit 5th of robotics. Title of the unit 5th is robo programming. We have divided this unit into two parts. In first part, we will discuss about the types of programming, programming language classification and language structure, whereas in second part we will discuss about the line following algorithm, line following program, direction and distance sensing by robo. So first we will discuss this part 1 of this unit regarding the robo programming. So robo programming, basically it is related with the movement of robo. It can be defined as the desired motion so that the robo may perform them without human intervention. As we are programming the robo, so job of the robo is to do some movement to carry out some useful work, like identifying and specifying the robo configuration, that is the pose of the end effector with respect to the base frame. Then types of robo programming. Broadly, robo programming is divided into three main types, that is joint level programming, which is related with the joint, then robo level programming and high level programming. High level programming, again it is subdivided into object level programming and task level programming. So we'll discuss one by one. Joint level programming, basic actions are position, that means movements, and individual joints of the robotic arm. Joint angle, in case of rotational joints, if the joint is rotational, then it is having some joint angle. And in case of prismatic or linear joint, we are having linear position. So that is means linear distance. So joint level programming, it is related with the movement of the robo or robotic part like end effector. Then second types is robo level programming. In this, the basic actions are positions and orientations of end effector. So it is related with the positions and orientation of end effector and the frame of reference attached to that end effector. Then third type is high level programming. High level programming, it is subdivided into object level and task level. In object level programming, basic actions are operation to be performed on the parts or relationship that must be established between parts, like picking some object, moving some object from one location to another location, that is related in the object level programming. Then task level programming, as robo is used to perform various useful tasks. So task level programming, it is a part of high level programming. In this, basic action specified by the program are complete task or subtasks, like painting the car, assembling the gearbox, so like that, or drilling something, so that are included in the task level programming, which is the sub part of high level programming. Then robo language structure. To implement the program, we require some robotic language. So that robotic language having some structure. So it mainly includes the operating system, that is OS. As we know, important of the OS, it is used to perform several functions like writing, editing and executing a program or code. In the robot textual language, it also helps to increase the performance of the system to a larger extent. For processing a robot language program, an operating system will require an interpreter or compiler. Interpreter means which is used to run every instruction, that is a single instruction of robo language, one by one. So that is called as the interpreter. Interpreter is a system software, and a compiler, where compiler is used to convert the instruction into machine level method by passing the complete program. Means if line by line compilation is there, then it is called as the interpreter, and if whole program is compiled at once, then it is called as the compiler. So compiler and interpreter are part of this operating system. So in robo language structure, operating system is main part, and it is having three different modes of operation. They are called as the monitor mode, edit mode and run mode. So we'll see the diagram of this robo language structure. This is the diagram for robo language structure. It is having three modes. This operating system having three modes, that is a monitor mode, edit mode, run mode. This monitor mode, it is called as the supervision mode. Edit mode, we can edit the program. In run mode, we can run the program. If some errors are there, then again that run program from this run mode again goes to edit mode. So edit and run, it is related with the program. whereas this monitor mode or supervisory mode, it is related with the tech pendant. Tech pendant is controller. We'll discuss about that tech pendant in next slide. Then this modes, this monitor mode and edit and run mode, that means this operating system is connected to some robo controller. Then robo controller having sensor as an input, and while after sensing some data, and this controller processes that data, and on the basis of that data it will do movement of the manipulator. Again, it is having input output devices. We'll discuss about this tech pendant. It is a control box for programming the motion of robo, also called as a tech box. Tech pendant is also called as the tech box. It is a control box for programming the motion of robo. So that's why it is connected to this monitor mode. The robo is set to learning or teach mode, and the pendant is used to control the robo step by step. Tech pendants are typically handheld devices and may be wired or wireless. So tech pendant is simply, it is some control box. It is a handheld device and it may be wired or wireless. Tech pendant is connected to monitor mode as shown in this diagram. So we'll discuss about this three mode operating system. We already discussed important operating system. So three modes. First is a monitor mode. The purpose of monitor mode is to control the complete OS. It is also known as supervisory mode. This mode allows the user to carry out some important tasks like defining the position with the help of tech pendant. Tech pendant, that is a tech box, that is controller box. Defining the position with the help of tech pendant, entering the sufficient speed for operating a robo, storing from new programs, bringing back the existing program for performing other tasks like edit and run. Because below that monitor mode, edit mode is there and run mode is there. So we have to bringing back the existing program for performing other tasks like edit and run. Then another mode is edit mode. As its name implies, edit mode, there is an instruction set for writing and editing the program, robo program. This process can be done by two different methods, such as editing or deleting the instruction and writing new instruction. So in edit mode, we can edit or delete some instruction, and we can write new instruction line in a program. Then last mode is run mode. In run mode, it is used to execute the sequence of program lines. This mode helps in checking the errors available on the programs. These errors are corrected with the help of language debugging method. This means debugging process, that means correction in the error, that is called as the debugging. For example, the points defined in the program may exceed the limits of moving the manipulator. Suppose the manipulator movement limit is 90 degree, and we are entering here 100 degree, so it shows error in this run mode. So after correcting this error, again this program is sent to edit mode. So this is all about the robo language structure. Next, we'll discuss about the programming language, robo programming language. So basically it is having two types, that is a first generation language and second generation language. First generation language, it is used to use a combination of command statement and tech pendant. Again, tech pendant is a tech box or controller box. It is a motion level language. Advanced tech pendant method. In first generation language, we use advanced tech pendant method, abilities to define manipulator motion, straight line interpolation, and elementary binary signals. So it is included in first generation language of robotic programming, whereas the limitation of first generation language, inability to specify complex arithmetic operation, inability to make use complex sensors and sensor data. So these limitations are overcome in second generation languages. So second generation language, it is structured programming language. As it is second generation, so improved language, more capabilities to make the robo move more intelligent. Features of second generation, this again motion control, advanced sensor capabilities, limited intelligence, communication and data processing. So that is these are the features of second generation programming language. Then robo programming language classification or types of robo programming language. Robo will require a programming language for describing the operation that are to be done. So for programming we require some language, and these are the various types of programming language. Basically there are 5 types of programming language that are robo programming language, like RAIL, AML, VAL, AL and RPL. So we'll discuss one by one. First we'll discuss the RAIL robo programming language. It will be best language for controlling two major tasks such as the manipulator and vision system. It is high level robo language based on Pascal. Pascal, it is one kind of language, so it is based on Pascal. It is a high level language and it will implement a Motorola 68000 central processor, take pendant and terminal. This language was designed by Automatix, it's one of the company, for arc welding and inspection purpose. So this RAIL language, it is used basically for arc welding. RAILs come with three different kinds of systems, like Hitachi process robo, which is used for arc welding, then assembly functions and vision system. And second programming language is AML, that is a manufacturing language. It is also high level language based on subroutine, which mainly implemented to manage assembly robo, end effector, active force feedback and Cartesian arm with hydraulic motor. So it is basically used for manufacturing. Then VAL, that is a variable assembly language. This language is designed with simple syntax. It is capable of illustrating the robo functions very easily. It includes two major tasks, like program instruction are used to provide VAL program, that is a variable assembly language program, in order to manage the robo function. And monitor commands are used to execute the user return program. Then AL language, AL robo language was developed in artificial intelligence. So AI is included in this AL language. It is second generation language. If the program is developed with high level code, then it should be written in Stanford Artificial Intelligence Language, SAIL, Stanford Artificial Intelligence Language. The AL system includes the big mainframe computers, and their configuration is given, that is 128 KB RAM memory and floating point processor. This language has got the capability to control two Puma. We have discussed about the Puma robo. So this language, that is AL language, which is a second generation language, it has a capability to control the two Puma 600 arms. 600 is the version of this Puma robo. Then last language is a RPL. RPL robo language makes the important checking the correction of control algorithm very easy. It can be done even by unskilled programmer, like foreman, production engineer. So RPL is a basic language which can be used by unskilled programmer. The RPL programs are translated to interpretable code with the help of compiler robo programming system. This robo language was designed in SRI International. So this is all about the part 1 of robotics unit 5. We'll discuss part 2. Thank you.